Now that we've got a better understanding of that where keyword, we're going to take a look at two more operations that you're going to frequently do on tables. That is, as you might guess, updating records and deleting records. So we're going to first take a look at how to update properties on some row inside of a table. Let's imagine for a second that maybe we want to update the population of Tokyo. Right now, inside of our database, Tokyo has a population of 38 million. Maybe in a year, they're going to have another million people, so we want to update it to 39 million. To do so, we would write out a query like what you see up here. Notice that the structure of the query looks very different from a select statement. We don't have a select statement because we're not fetching any data. We're only trying to update some data. So we're going to write out a keyword of update. We'll then list the name of the table that we want to make an update to. We'll then use a new keyword that we haven't seen before called set. Set is going to describe the property that we want to change on some record. So in this case, we're going to set the population value to 39,505,000. And then finally, we're going to specify exactly which records we want to update by using a where statement. So in this case, we're going to say find all the records where name equals Tokyo. In our case, we've only got one row inside of here with the name of Tokyo. So we're going to find that one row right there and update its population to 39 million. Okay, let's go ahead and try to test this out very quickly. So back over here, I'm going to do a update cities. We're going to set the population to 39,505,000. And we only want to update the record where the name is equal to Tokyo. So I'm going to run that. And we get back a response here that just says the update was successful. So if we want to actually see what changed, we now have to run a query on our cities table and fetch all the rows inside of it. Once we do so, we should be able to verify that the new population for Tokyo is 39 million. So I'm going to remove that query and replace it with a select star from cities. I'll run that, and then sure enough, I can now see that Tokyo has a population of 39 million. Okay, so that looks pretty good. Now, one thing I want to mention very quickly is that this where statement over here can sometimes be just a little bit tricky. Whenever you write that where statement, if you are trying to update one specific record, you need to make sure that your where statement is specific enough that you're only going to update one city. So for example, you might may or may not know this, there are cities across the world that are named after other cities. So for example, in the United States, it turns out that there are actually cities in the US called Shanghai, same name as Shanghai in China. So we might imagine that if our table of cities here eventually grew large enough, we might have another city inside of here with the name of Shanghai, but its country would be United States. So if we tried to update some population value of China and we provided a name of Shanghai, that would update not only the Shanghai in China to some new value, but it would also update Shanghai in the United States to some new value as well. So we just need to keep this in mind and be very careful when we are writing out these where statements. Now, if this sounds a little bit scary and it sounds like you might accidentally update some record you don't mean to update, don't sweat it. In just a little bit in this course, I'm going to show you a foolproof solution to make sure that anytime you update a record, it always updates exactly what you want to update. Okay, so having said that, this is the update command. Pretty simple, straightforward in nature. It's rather infrequent that we ever make really complicated update statements. You will usually see that they are rather simple and straightforward, like what you see right here. Now, we do still have to understand a little bit more about how to delete rows as well, so let's take a look at delete in just a moment.